Okay, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today is actually December 29th. And I'm gonna be making this YouTube video, and when I gotta do a part two, I gotta do part two. So it is currently 8:06. So I'm gonna go through on my list of things, the new attitude for 2024. I think it's gonna do what I wanna do. It's basically what I just said, new attitude, but that's just the title of the video. But it's not just a new attitude, it's about new goals, what I'm gonna do in life, and just basically a lot of it's my opinion. Like, the whole channel is under my opinion, obviously. And oh, let me put this down first. Okay, so first I'm gonna start off with post YouTube videos from 2022. So not only have they been recorded a year ago for 2023, but they're not gonna be posted till over a year later, because I just haven't, I don't know, it's just like, if I recorded like a long time ago but I don't like edited that same month, at the very most that same month, then it's not likely it's gonna be posted in the same year or in this, or close proximity. My camera is not really charged, the battery's not really charged, so it might actually have to be a part two. Maybe not a part two, maybe a different clips, because I thought about doing my makeup for this. I took out my eyelashes like last night. You know, I only do my makeup for work now. I mean, I did my makeup for school as well sometimes, but that 30 minute drive is kicking my behind. So yeah, kind of difficult to want to do your makeup, that's a drive 30 minutes, and then I don't care what y'all say, 30 minute drive from Pearland to UH is not my friend, but I don't have a choice because you raised in the ghetto and I'm not living in the ghetto. Well, this is on campus. I'm not living in those ghetto ass apartments. Sorry to God, I do. I heard some bad things. I read some bad things. Not going. Not staying on the... I stay on campus, but not those apartments. Beyond the point. So, anywho, caring about what other drivers on the road think of me or do. You could bleep. I could probably be so nervous. Like, oh my God, you're riding my behind. I don't care. You're riding my butt. I don't care. Hold on, let me take these off. This is annoying. This is why I want to do makeup, because I don't like wearing my glasses and I don't have my contacts. I ran out. Like, I used my contacts for longer than I was supposed to. That the contact was pink. My contacts turned pink. I know. I knew what I was doing. They were just so old, man. Like, I kept them in my eye, so I couldn't. Anywho, I don't care. One day I was, where was I? I think, what's that name of the road? Main Street? I was on Main Street, I believe. And no, I was on the Main Street. I was trying to get to Main Street. I don't remember. But so like there was like a bridge right there, and then like a bridge is here, but the light was here. So you know on the bridge, and when there's like an exit next to it, there's like this white part. So my car was like on the white part. A car or two passed me, didn't pass me just fine. I was not on the highway. I was not on the bridge. I was very much on the street more than I was even on the bridge. And then three cars, beep, 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 beep. And it's just like, now, y'all be a total a-hole. Because you know dang well I'm not in your way. You know dang well I'm not in your way. But I didn't move my car, and I did. I know I waited till the UPS truck stayed back, and I got in front of the UPS truck. Because it was a FedEx truck, actually. Because first of all, I'm not in your way. And two, I'm not missing my exit. I mean, I'm not missing my right turn for y'all. Fuck no. I'm not missing my right turn. I'm not. So you can holler and beep at me, I don't care, but I was in nobody's way. Let me get that clear for y'all. Stick in the mud, rock high, stick in my mics. I don't know if I ever post a YouTube video, but I feel like some people out there are just real a-holes. I might do it, I mean, I don't even know if I have it, because I used to cock it too fast. So I don't know what to say, but like, I really want to do something with my feelings and opinions about tickets on the internet. And these I say on the internet, I don't mean the only internet stuff, but it just seems that regular people that you meet on the street will feel and say, because it's all these people are. I'm not really talking about like dramatic reactions to, or like, you know, you can tell when something like crazy on the internet, but you also tell when something like mediocre on the internet. Like, people say this in person. So stuff like that, I want to do something with that. Might do it on YouTube, might just write it down and make a book, I don't know. But yeah, just some, I feel like some, sticking to my mics would be like, well, you should have done that. You should have done that. You should have gone on the bridge, or I don't know, got in that 2-hour line to get to the red light. I'm like, no. I didn't even know I was cutting in front of people. I was following a car, actually. I thought this car knew something that I didn't know, so I just followed that car. And I was like, oh, we're skipping the line. But I don't care. I got my right turn. So, F you. You want to ride behind, that's too bad. You want to be by me, that's too bad. I'm going to do what I got to do to get to where I got to go. As long as I ain't abusing no laws and causing accidents, all right? Now we're going to finish school. At this point, I don't care. Because I was in, first of all, this one, I'm glad I'm not friends with some girl that did go to Mo. Because she was like an honors, I don't know if she was an honors student, but I know she was taking classes like dual enrollment or pre-AP or whatnot. She's like, yeah, I'm going to finish school early. And I don't know if she actually did finish school early because she changed her major. I'm not saying that you can't change your major finish all the time. You know, once you already spend time, I don't remember. But yeah, it's kind of just like there was some weird obsession with just finishing early or finishing before people. And at first I was like, I'm taking summer classes, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I'm getting out of here because I really do. But now I'm kind of just saying, like, you know what? After U of H did jack up my enrollment, and I don't care if they find this video, that's fine. As long as I get my degree from y'all, I mean, I said what I said, y'all did jack up my enrollment. Supposed to get in your school in the summertime. Didn't tell them I got in. Supposed to get a letter for the springtime of this year. Still didn't send my letter to let me know I got in. You did not let me know. There was no way for me to know. So you guys had to choose for me to push back my enrollment to the fall. That was not my choice or my decision. And again, for you asshole mics, I would like to know how did I find out I got into a school without the email or without the letter. Because UNT sent me a letter. And an email, actually. Alright. Because I have minds of things I've seen on the internet. Actually, here on YouTube. People are saying how their counselor steered them the wrong way. People are like, how you blame your counselor? That's totally your fault. You can just go online and find it yourself and put it in all your own classes. It was like, you dumb butts. They're literally there to help us pass. Not pass. They're literally there to help us finish school. If they do their job wrong, that is 100% their fault and not a student's fault. They are supposed to be trusted to steer us in the correct way. So for you asshole mics, I don't know what I'm calling that. Sticking with mics, people can be wrong. People can make a decision for somebody else or with somebody else and be the fault of that. Like, other people could be the fault of your downfall. It can. It's the same thing as a doctor prescribing you the wrong medication, a counselor telling you to go to the wrong classes. Whether you research it or not, they're trusted people and they still steers you in the wrong direction. Alright, I don't know what it is with these people. But let me go ahead and skip to one on the last, to the second page. OMG, I got ink on my sweatpants. Okay, I don't need to go to the bag. I know what it says. I'm not dealing with Mr. Tough Guy and I'm not dealing with Mr. Tough Woman. Those people gets on my effing nerves. It's okay to not be okay. It's okay to struggle. It's okay you can't do every single thing. Tell people no. You're getting on my nerves. You're getting on mine. I don't like dealing with attitude. I don't like dealing with the, well, you just gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta figure it out. Sometimes you just can't. Sometimes you gotta let it go. Just don't do it. You don't gotta be tough. You're not Superman. And you sure as hell is not Spider-Man. You're just a human being. Please relax. You can't do something. If something's too hard to you, have too much on your plate, drop it. Drop something. Be like, no, I can't go. No, I'm not doing it. I'm tired. I'm gonna go to bed. I'm hurt. I'm in my feelings. I need a therapist. Whatever you need to do to stop putting on this front that you're the toughest dude or you're the toughest woman, either do it as far as possible or just stop. I think it'd be easier to get away from me. But it was, which I don't mind either. I'm not telling you to change for me. But it does quite annoying to deal with those type of people. Because just like, damn, like, be in your feelings. I mean, I'm not an emotional person, but dang, like, stop acting like you can't cry. Not acting like you can't say, no, I'm hurt. Just say it. That get on my nerves. I cannot stand it. That's how I know. I hate all my life. I said that 100%. I don't like those type of men either. I'm not dating. I would never marry that man. I've always dated men that are open with their emotions. And they're not gay. Because you men that can't be open with your emotions, I would call you a bitch before I call a man that's open about his emotions a bitch. You're the bitch. Because you can't even say you're hurt or sad. Speaking of that, not dealing with men with manhood trauma. That's right. Not calling it trauma, not calling it hurt. It's pre-manhood trauma. I don't care. My dad said I gotta cry, so you know, leave me alone. Don't talk to me. Well, you know, my dad cheated, my mom said, that's all I knew. Don't speak to me. I don't give a damn. You know, everything raised on my shoulder. I feel like I gotta be this, I gotta be that. F the people and F society. Will you come to me? I need you to already have that figured out and clear. you only got a good, like, 2-3 months out of me for me to actually try to be a good person. I had to try to be a fake therapist to help you out. But at the time, I'm like, sir, you gotta go see a therapist to leave me alone. I'm not dealing with manhood trauma. You will not hurt me or get me caught up in no BS because you're fucked up. Due to manhood. Not just out of life in general. Due to manhood and how men grow up. Because obviously I'm a woman. I don't know how y'all grew up. But I dated enough men to know that I'm dealing with certain shit. And I've been around enough men to know what I'm not dealing with due to manhood. And that was one of them. I need you to be a regular human being. Not a tough man. Not a, I'm the man. Leave me alone. Please. Thank you. Now, actually, let me go in order. I hear jamming and talking. But I mean, everything I say it. It's actually on here, too. Not caring about what others' opinions and everyone... Others' opinions. Like, I've seen a video of a grandmother say that she had a boyfriend. But number said her... granddaughter or her granddaughter or her daughter was like, my dad, let's say it was a daughter, my dad just said that you stopped cheating on him. And the grandma was like, oh yeah, he used to have a boyfriend. I don't know what she said verbatim, but you know, you get the gist. And the kind of was like, well, hey, don't you go ahead and judge a grandma, or you know, like, he said you don't know what they've been through. They still together, that's beautiful. I'm over here like, that ain't beautiful. I'm sorry, that's just my opinion, my perspective. I don't believe a couple's old, young, whatever, well, especially old, being together for 20 or 30 years with somebody disrespected the other person. Whether grandpa did it first or grandma did it first, it doesn't matter. I would never view it as beautiful. I'd rather be a woman that my cousin has voted on me. I'd rather be divorced 3 times. Like Louis said, out of all of us, I'd be divorced 3 times by 80. We don't even date, so how am I gonna get married? 3 times like that, that's crazy. 3 times? That's wild. I wanna be married 1 time. Now twice, okay, that's cool. But 3 times, like, listen, I ain't getting married the third time. We're gonna have to just, you know, physical bump, whatever. But a third time, no. 2 times, probably. But 1 time, I want to be married 1 time. Anywho, and I'm kind of just like, I really don't care. This is my opinion. I don't believe in that. I don't believe in staying in marriage for a long time when cheating happened. I don't think it's beautiful. I don't think it's cute. None of that. I really, really don't. I just don't. But some people just care about the longevity of the relationship and not what happened in a relationship. Now, y'all might be saying, those up and downs, every couple of up and downs. Infidelity, leaving your partner for someone else, is not an up and down. That's disrespect. That's how I hate y'all at. That's how I don't love you. That's what that is. And I don't agree with that. I think that's jacked up, actually. I'll be 75 years old and leave a man. Try me. I'll be 50 and leave a man. Don't even do that. I don't care. I would die alone before I'd be like, oh yeah, baby. I made it 5 years old. Your grandpa cheated on me. Girl, no. Are we still together? Oh, absolutely not. We bought our funeral things together? Give me my money back. I'm getting my grave somewhere else away from this man. But I'm praying to God that I'm not dealing with that. I'm going to marry a good, loyal man. I am marrying a good, loyal man. Period. But I'm just saying I don't agree with that. But that's somebody else's perspective. Somebody has to find it beautiful. They think it's great and beautiful that a couple have been there for so long after... stuff her down, but I don't like that. I'm not super duper grown. I'm not making decisions for the family or anything. This is not my house. Basically, I'm about to tell you why I said this is not my house. And that I don't want traditions in my home. I already knew this when I was a child. Okay, not a child. Maybe when I was younger. That when I had my own house apartment, that I was not going to be a hostess. And you can't feel the type of way or anything about that. Failing or friend or not. It's my house. It's my space. You're not going to talk down to me. You're not going to tell me. You're not going to ask me to do anything that includes having other people in my space, other cars in my driveway, dishes in my sink, extra food in my fridge. For what? Because I have my own and you just want to be here for Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year's, Easter, whatever the case may be. That's my decision fully. When I get married, that's me and my husband's decision. I don't care. I don't want it. That has to be a choice. You cannot just say, Lamella, you're not in line to have people in my house. Have company in my house. I choose that. Nobody else does. Barely my husband. No, I'm kidding. I don't know. I feel like, I don't know. I always date, like, talking to guys or, like, well, I think I talk to them when you see them outside, but, like, when you get to dating them, they're like, oh, no, I'm actually, like, really quiet. It's like, dang, boy, I'm quiet, too. We can't be together. But, you know, I technically don't. I don't know if I ever would like marry a guy that like likes a host. I don't think I would, because that would not go well with my personality. Or like, my grandma was complaining to me, talking to me, and trying to explain to me why I should have decorated our front yard at the age of 20 years old. This is not my house. My daddy wanted that yard decorated, he would have had the yard decorated. He didn't get the yard decorated. What that got to do with me? I'm 20 years old. I could care less about this house having lights on it. And my daddy paid somebody to put the lights on it. So my daddy would have paid somebody to decorate the front yard. If that's what he wanted to do. And no, I do not agree with my grandmother. This is not my house. If my mom or my dad wanted it decorated, it would have been decorated. And my grandma was like, well, daddy, I got to ask you to do it. I was like, yes, I do. Because how else would I want to know? How else would I know? How else would I know to do something and nobody tell me to do something? I'm not like my cousin that's going to do whatever. This is not my house like that. I do not make decisions for this house. I just don't. This is not mine. I don't care if it's my mom or my dad's house. I don't care if I'm their child. It's not my house to make those type of decisions. It's not, period. So I'm not going to do it. If my daddy wanted the house decorated, it would have been decorated. We would have to go pick out decorations at Home Depot. We didn't go. Or Target, or Walmart, whatever. We didn't do it. So it's not going to be decorated. This house, the decoration of the house, my mama wanted her house decorated. She decorated her house. Because she's a grown woman who bought this house, who wanted her house to look a certain way. So she did that. This is her house, not mine. It's not. I'm literally back here because I don't go to school out of Houston. It's not really my house like that. It's just my parents' house. I'm at that age where, yeah, this is my bedroom, that is my bathroom, that is my parking spot in the driveway. But outside of that, it's me like, this is whatever mom and dad want to do in their house, mom and dad will do. If they need help, that's when they will speak to me about what they decide to do with their house. Theirs. Their decision. Now, my daddy just bought some new little stuff to put outside. Did he ask me about that? No, because it's his house. I'm not concerned with dating. I really don't. Listen, if a boarder hit me up, I'm tired of it, okay? I don't go to school on campus no more, and I'm not about to go to school on campus next semester because I can't drive. I'm tired of 30-minute drive, and I'm not living on campus because I just said, why am I living? I'm not living on campus. I'm not living near campus because I just want to tell you why I'm not living near campus. And I just can't. I just don't go outside like that. Boys don't see me, and I don't be pressed about the issue. Not concerned about making friends either. I haven't made friends in years. I'm kind of used to not making friends at this point. So I'm kind of just like, kind of the norm to not have friends anymore. And last time I was friends with a girl, it did not go well. Girls are weird. It just didn't go well. They're weird. The ones that shouldn't be your friends are weird. Other girls like me, regular girls, sure. I'm not saying I'm proud to not have friends. I know on one point on the internet, it was like, I got a friends crew. And I'm kind of just like, it's not really all that. Or they have such a negative opinion about having friends. And it's really not all that bad. So I'm not trying to say that I hate girls or I hate guy friends. It's just that I never really made friends as a person. Like, going to school, middle school, elementary, high school, whatever the case may be, college, never really made friends. Not being embarrassed by having anxiety. My mom used to be like, oh my god, I'm not raising a worried child. Like, you did not raise me to be this way, please. Two, yes, I need to be my meds. I don't care you judge me for being on my meds or not. We're up on them up. I don't care. Yes, I need help. I'd rather get help than be angry at the world, than being terrified to go outside the door. I'd rather help myself and do better as a human being than be some human being who can't go to a therapist, who can't go to a doctor to go get help. Because black people don't do that. Because that's so embarrassing. Like, oh my gosh. Like, what I'm about to do? Be a crazy person? Like, I can't take antidepressants even though I'm sad because antidepressants. I can't take anxiety pills because, you know, people think I'm crazy. Something's wrong with me. I can't do it. Not that person. I need help. I'm going to go get help. Period. Next. Being embarrassed and having dyslexia. Listen, it's hard for me to spell some things sometimes. You know, actually, speaking of this, I'm taking single lessons and it's No, that's how you actually say the vowels. Anywho, there's this singing, there's a vocal warm-up, I believe. And the way you, the letters, actually, I think it's like an alphabet. It's like an alphabet that we're not talking. Okay, my camera literally just cut out. Anyways, I was trying to say, but this last one, it's actually a vocal, an alphabet that is, taught, I think, in a different language or a different school. I don't know. And it's like the E and the A, the I is pronounced differently, whatever. So I went to go tell my mom, I'm like, yeah, the reason why I have a difficult time with these vocal warm-ups is because the way you pronounce these letters, I mean, the way you sing the letters and how they sound are totally different. And I said, I told my teacher, I was like, hey, I have dyslexia. So, you know, it might be a little bit more difficult for me to, like,
read it one way and then say it a totally different way. And my mom was like, well, maybe we're not trying hard enough with your dyslexia. Maybe we're not, I don't know, study yourself a lot. I don't know, something, you're not practicing with dyslexia enough. I'm like, I accommodated myself. What more should I do with dyslexia? It would never be treated. It's not a treatable, what is it? Disability. It's not. I would accommodate myself, but saying I'm not trying hard enough or that I'm not practicing enough, like, what should I do? Read until I find something difficult to? I don't know. But I accommodate myself. Like, one more try, I've done it. I don't know. Okay, I'm going to do a few more before I'm going to do my makeup and let the battery charge, because I prefer to do it on my camera than hold a phone. Especially because, like, I need my screen protector is on here. Let me see if I, like, lift it and see if that makes it better. Did it change how it looks? Yeah, you can kind of see it. I think you can see the film a little bit, because the film is a little bit cracked on here. But, I mean, and my hair is short. I want to see. Hopefully it's longer by the end of 2024, because I cut it off. And I was scared I'm going to have to cut my hair off again. Cause I bleached it, and we cut off my hair. Cause y'all, my hair is this short, flat iron. I want you to repeat. No. I'm lying. It was this short, flat iron. Listen to me. It was this short, flat iron. This is where it is curly. So yeah, it mattered how short my hair was. Yeah, I cried in April when I had to cut it. If I had to cut it again, I would cry harder. Is it my fault? 100%. But I'll still be upset. This is my fault. I know. I'm not comparing myself to anybody else. Yes, girls are going to have longer hair than I do. Yes, girls are going to have black girls. I don't definitely not compare myself to no white woman. I'm going to tell you that. Now, I'm so tired of that. I wish black mothers. That's so funny for me saying this. For saying the word black mothers and teaching their daughters. You're going to realize later in the video why it's funny. That our long hair and black women. Obviously, there's obvious, like, oh, her hair is curly, not her back long, but it looks different for us. It looks different. Like, why would we compare our curly hair to some straight-ass hair? Be self-aware, why? And first of all, it should never matter. Long hair, short hair, don't care. Whatever, you know, depending on the age group that finds this video, you know the song I'm talking about. I'm going to play it, though, for sure. Make myself edit. I didn't really want to edit the video that hard, but I might. I'll be chatting. I'm going to say it in Texas. But I hear, I think, Kai, I don't know, some other streamer, YouTuber, be saying that, but whatever. Yes, girls can have a flat stomach than I do. Yes, girls are going to have a bigger butt than I do. And even in 2023, in the 2020, somebody asked my butt was fake. F you, bitch. It was a boy, too. And I'm so tired of people being used to, like, plastic surgery to the extent that they seen a natural big butt. You had the absolute nerve to ask if it was fake. Boy, you're gonna get out of my face. Out of my face. Out. Like, what? Is this big butt fake? My mama got it. My grandma got it. My auntie got it. My cousin got it. We all got big butts. It's called being black, honey. I was literally talking to, I think she's a new friend, maybe acquaintance. She's Hispanic. We were talking about how everybody and their mama getting plastic surgery when Hispanic women and black women naturally have these big butts, naturally have these hips, naturally have these thighs, naturally have all that junk in their trunk, and still got a flat stomach, or a nice size stomach, still do. Like, this is a normal body. Ethnic women been having that bad bitch body, been have it. It's not new. Stop, shut up. Kim Kardashian got my, like, stop. Stop it. She started this trend. She let it go. She's like, honey, this big butt not working out for me. And everybody know I'm going to gym for it. So before you guys start this ass, it ain't gym grown. And it ain't that chamfer grown either. It came from God and my mom. All right? Just letting you know now at 20 years old. So whenever I'm famous or whenever people know me, they will know for sure that this butt is mine and the stomach has always been flat. Thank you. Next. Oh, and also that a lot of people are beautiful. I thought that having a pretty face was rare. It's not rare. A lot of women are drop-dead gorgeous. A lot. A lot of women are, like, very, very pretty girls. It's mostly fun out there to be a boy. Because a lot of women are stunning. And you have to be confident with yourself. Because if you're not, it can be hard out there. Because, like I just said, a lot of women are gorgeous. I go to University of Houston. I have an Instagram account. A lot of women are pretty. It's not that rare to be pretty. It's not that rare to see pretty women. I mean, it's not in the slightest. No matter the race, it's not that rare. Not ashamed to, ashamed at all to unfollow or block people. I mean, like, I think because we're not being in person, we'd be like, oh my gosh, I don't want to unfollow and be rude. I will unfollow you. I don't care if you play soccer together, we went to school together, high school, college, we used to talk to each other, we used to be friends, whatever the case may be. If we don't talk now, if I get bothered by your content or post, I don't find muting you, I will just unfollow you. I don't care if you still follow me, I'm still going to unfollow you. You can unfollow me back. I don't care about my follower likes or things on Instagram. At least say I don't have friends. Whoever's liking my post, I don't know you like that. Or, I mean, I might know of you because we went to school together. But, I mean, other than that, I'm kind of just like... and family. But that's it. So, I mean, please unfollow me back. I don't care. Because I definitely unfollow some people for a reason. For a very specific reason at that. Whenever they're speaking up for my case, speaking up for myself, or okaying you to the end of time. I mean, that's pretty much explaining to me. Either I'm going to speak for myself, be like, no, I don't agree with that. No, I don't feel that way. No, you can't say that to me. Or they're going to be like, all right, okay, cool. All right, shut up. Stop. Okay. Until you stop talking to me. But it depends on me. I might be like, ugh, don't you say it to me? You're like, no, I don't agree with that. Like, no, I'm not going to do that. Or they're going to be like, okay, just not do it. Pick your poison. Okay, it's 5 minutes. I have a few more, as you can see, I talked for a long time. Like, I thought each one of these was gonna take me 30 seconds to say. Absolutely not. I keep talking. So, and you would think I would have put my battery with a charger by now, but I haven't. But I'm gonna try a new makeup look for work Sunday. It's gonna be the most basic look ever on purpose, though. Not just because I can't do makeup. Just because I wanna go with a clean girl, light makeup look. So, yeah. And I might record it. Waking up at 6 a.m. Okay, I'm lying. Waking up at 5 a.m. and pulling on the camera is crazy. But we'll see.
Okay, I'm back on the camera. With my makeup slightly done, I feel like the lighting of my mirror makes me look way too light. I did not like my makeup from makeup I just did. First of all, I hate doing makeup with dirty brushes. I don't know what's the obsession with dirty brushes and dirty hair brushes. Making it better to do your hair or to do your makeup, but it's not it for me. I clean my brushes because it's easier to use, and I definitely clean my makeup brushes because it gives me a cleaner and better look. But I rushed the makeup look, even though I didn't have to, because I mean, it is currently 9:49. So I didn't really need to rush it because now my battery is it says it's full. Okay, so let me go back. 100%, no. Not being part of the all black or the all black family talks. And we're all black family, all black women were taught. My parents never taught me struggle love. I don't know why black women keep saying that we were taught or that we are pushed to date a broke man. Not even a full 5 minutes ago, my grandmother just told me to marry a man, date a man that can take care of me. She ain't never said, Madeline, even he a poor man. Just date a man that loves you. That's not what I ever said. She said, make sure he can take care of you. You can buy what you want and what you need. That's what I was told. That's how I'm raised. And not being a gold digger, I don't understand why you call women gold digger, black, white, red, orange, yellow, Asian, whatever the case may be. Calling a woman, a grown woman, a woman that's looking for marriage, who's going to buy a home, who's going to buy a car, who's going to raise children, who's going to send children to college, that they're gold diggers for wanting to marry a man that makes a certain amount of money. You dumb asses. Some of you men out there will never be husbands, or you won't be good husbands, because you don't understand why the man should make a certain amount of money and why a man should have a certain amount of money to take care of a woman. Because you're not taking care of just you, you're taking care of somebody else. And there's some people that do it, but some of it is struggle love. And sometimes you do need a certain job that makes that so you can make an X amount of money to take care of a family. That's just what it is. Whether you agree with it or not, which is fine, you disagree. But I'm not marrying a man who can't take care of at least me. Because you can't take care of two people, we're not getting married. And I'm not mean take care of me 100%. Like, I'm going to have my own job. But you're still the man, point blank, period. And if you can't do that, then I can't have children with you, and I can't live in a house with you. Because now we're going to have financial problems. And that's stupid to marry into that. And I don't know why, but I'm going to keep saying that we were taught to do that. I wasn't taught that. A lot of negative things that people say, we weren't taught this, we weren't taught that. We, as a you, your mama, and your siblings. But we as a whole, absolutely not. Absolutely not. Yeah, but all my mom, we were raised with good self-esteem. Your mother taught you that. Oh, we were taught, you know, having this hair and curly hair was ugly. You gotta get your mom. Yours. This is not a universal, I mean, it could be universal, but not all black women have been taught those things in all the households, like, at all. Like, at all.
Okay, so I'm just going to end the video here. I'm just going to do a part two instead because it's about an hour and I'm 4 minutes long. And that's pretty long to me. I keep looking. It makes me look like I'm looking sideways, but yeah, I'm looking straight at the camera. I'm looking right at my face. But yeah, it's really long. I know I'm going to talk for a long time in this edit. But thank you for watching. So it should only be about 31, 32 minutes now. And then the next video should be probably, I'm thinking, like 35 minutes. And I hope I'm going to post them in the same week. I had, like, day near a month off of school. And then I record or post not one video. I mean, I recorded two or three. Because I recorded some of the things. But, like I said, who knows when I get posted. And then the storage on this dang laptop is not a lot. Even though it's kind of weird. No, my dad only paid for storage on my phone. Which that lady should not have put on my phone. We did not agree to that. But anyways. Bye. Thank you guys.